Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to the subject Digital Image Processing. This video is from second chapter, that is Digital Image Fundamentals. In this chapter, we have first of all seen the elements of human visual perception. We have gone through learning of the structure of human eye along with how the image is formed there. We have also seen the brightness adaptation along with the discrimination with respect to the human eye. Further, we have seen the role of light and electromagnetic spectrum into the image formation. We have also seen how the image can be sensed by using the single sensor, the sensor strip and the sensor array. Now, we have known to the importance as well as the procedure how the image sampling and quantization is carried so that the continuous type of information that has been obtained by just sensing the image element is converted to the digital form. Further, we have seen the digital representation of the images mathematically as well as onto the monitor, that is graphical representation we can see. And just now we have talked about the spatial resolution and intensity resolution. So for digital images, for betterment of the quality and the result, we always want the spatial resolution and the intensity resolution to highest value. But the digital representation of the images limits us to the coordinate components as well as the intensity components. We can say the coordinate values are discretized for the two dimensions, capital M and capital N, we can say, and for the intensity, the levels are represented by capital L. It is a function like 2 to the power k. So depending on number of bits with which we are representing it, so those many number of intensity levels will be only there. But we always want the image to be developed with higher number. So in image interpolation is one technique where we can enhance the information, we can filling the missing portion into the digital representation of the image. So let us see the topic image interpolation. So here we have the topic image interpolation from the chapter Digital Image Fundamentals, part of digital image processing. So we begin here. Interpolation is basically a tool that is used extensively in the tasks such as zooming of the image. We always want more details into the image, or if you want some minute details to see, we generally zoom the image. Or if you want to see the overall view, overall components present into the image, we sometimes shrink it also. So zooming in and zooming out operations here, zooming and shrinking, along with the rotation of the image, the geometric corrections of the image, that are very much essential while working with, handling with the digital images is there. So that is actually made possible with the basic tool, that is image interpolation. Next, the principal objective of this image interpolation is to resize the image. So shrinking, that means zooming out or zooming in, will give us resizing of the image. So these are basically the image resampling methods. Those who have the background of digital signal processing, they may be knowing the multi-rate digital signal processing, where interpolation and decimation are the two terms where we change the sampling rate with respect to the signal. So here the signal is a two-dimensional signal, that is image. So image signal, if resampled, that provides us the zooming, shrinking, the rotation, the geometric corrections with the help of image interpolation, which is basically image resampling method here. So fundamentally, we have image interpolation as the process of using known data to estimate the values of unknown locations. Further, we take a simple example. In this example, we try to get the image of size 500 by 500 pixels to get enlarged by 1.5 times. So the size of the image has to be increased, right from 500 by 500 pixels to 750 by 750 pixels, so that it will be 1.5 times greater there. or we can also take the example 500 and 500 pixel size image enlarged by 2 times, that is 1000 by 1000 pixels we can say. So to do this particular task, the simple way is to visualize zooming effect. So we can have the creation of imaginary 750 by 750 grid with the same pixel spacing as the original, and then shrink it so that it fits exactly over the original image. Next, the pixel spacing into the shrunken 750 by 750 grid will be less than that of the pixel spacing into the original image. Further, the intensity assignment is to be done. So that is performed by assigning the intensity of its closest pixel into the original image to the new pixel into the 750 by 750 grid. So after intensity assignment, we expand it to the original specified size to obtain the zoom effect, zoom image. So this is the procedure that we have carried out. This method is basically popular with the name nearest neighbor interpolation, because into this particular method of interpolation, the assignment of each new location of the intensity of its nearest neighbor into the original image is done. Hence the name nearest neighbor interpolation. Now this particular method offers certain limitations, because the method has tendency to produce the undesirable artifacts such as severe distortion or straight edges. So because of this nature that has been shown by this particular method, nearest neighbor interpolation, this is infrequently used. So to overcome the limitations of the nearest neighbor interpolation, certain more techniques of interpolation are also offered into digital image processing. So as compared to the nearest neighbor, the more suitable approach is one we have, that is bilinear interpolation. In bilinear interpolation, the use of 4 nearest neighbors to estimate the intensity at a given location is done. So for bilinear interpolation, the assignment value is assigned by using the equation. That equation is V of xy is obtained by ax plus by plus cxy plus d here. So xy being the spatial coordinates, these are the 4 terms involved along with the xy. So these are giving us the estimation of the new intensity value here. So this bilinear interpolation method gives a better result as compared to the nearest neighbor interpolation we discussed, and with a modest increase into the computational burden. So the computation was very much simple into the nearest neighbor method, but it has increased with the bilinear interpolation, but it gives the better result. Distortions are less as compared to the nearest neighbor. Next to the bilinear interpolation, we have one more advanced method, that is bicubic interpolation, where the computation is again increased to give the better result. So bicubic interpolation method involves the 16 nearest neighbors of a point. In the earlier method, bilinear one, we had the 4 neighbors. So right from the 4 neighbors, it has been increased to 16 nearest neighbors at the single point here. So the intensity value assigned to the point xy is obtained using the equation given by V of xy. It has been given by the summation I extending from 0 to 3, another summation j extending from 0 to 3, a suffix ij in product with x to the power I, y to the power j here. So here I and j, these are actually the 2 dimensions, discrete dimensions of the image. We can say the number of rows and number of columns in general. And for the specific region with respect to the point at the center, if you are talking about the 16 nearest neighbor, we take those ranges from 0 to 3 for I and 0 to 3 again for the j here. So these 16 coefficients are determined from the 16 equations into the 16 unknowns. Earlier into the equation, we had the 4 terms onto the RHS. So this will offer us 16 terms into the RHS to represent V of xy, the new intensity levels. So generally, this bicubic interpolation does a better job as compared to the nearest neighbor as well as the bilinear interpolation. and it preserves the fine details than the bilinear counterpart and the nearest neighbor counterpart at the expense of computational complexity. So bicubic interpolation is popular one. It is also used into the Adobe Photoshop and Corel Photo Paint applications of image processing. Now we have some example image here. We have the six parts into this particular image. Talking about the first part, image is reduced to 72 dots per inch and zoom back to its original size, that is 3692 by 2812 pixels using the nearest neighbor interpolation. That was the simplest one, but that offered the distortion into the image that we can see into the first part. Now the next part, part B, is obtained by image shrunk and zoomed using the bilinear interpolation. So it has offered certain better results as compared to the nearest neighbor interpolation that we can see into the image. Next to the bilinear interpolation, just now what we discussed, that is bicubic interpolation method. So it has better results as compared to the previous two, part A and part B. So this way the first three parts, part A, B, C, are here with the three different methods of interpolation: nearest neighbor, bilinear and bicubic interpolation. Now we have the latter three parts, that is part D, E and F. So again we have the sequence same for the nearest neighbor. First of all, for part D, for part E we have bicubic bilinear interpolation, and for the part F we have bicubic interpolation, and the shrinking down with 150 dots per inch instead of 72 dots per inch that we have seen into the first three parts. So with more number of dots per inch, that is 150, so it means that the spatial resolution has increased and this particular interpolation method gives these particular results. So we can summarize this particular topic that the use of more neighbors into the interpolation method offers us more complexity into the technique, and such as using the splines, wavelets, we can extend from bicubic interpolation to these particular techniques, and that in some instances can yield better results as compared to the three methods: nearest neighbor, bilinear and bicubic interpolation in some of the applications. Preserving the fine detail into the exceptionally important consideration of the image generation for 3D graphics and into the medical image processing is important. Thereupon, the image interpolation methods are extensively used and are important one to preserve these fine details. Thus, the extra computational burden seldom is justifiable in such application for general purpose digital image processing, where the bilinear or bicubic interpolation typically are the methods of choice. These are the popular methods. So I hope you have understood image interpolation method. Into the next lecture, we are going to discuss about the basic relationships between the pixels. That is again a part into the second chapter, digital image fundamentals. So for getting such more details and the topics into the subject digital image processing, you can subscribe to eKida channel. Thank you.